वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग किड्स, आई एम मोहना रानी, योर कंप्यूटर टीचर. होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड फाइन, सेफ एट होम. ओके, इन दिस पैंडमिक सिचुएशन प्लीज डोंट कम आउट, वेयर योर मास्क, वॉश योर हैंड्स फ्रीक्वेंटली, बी सेफ. होप यू ऑल वुड हैव एंजॉयड योर दिवाली. ओके, वुड हैव सेलिब्रेटेड सेफली. Now in this video we are going to learn our lesson 4 book back exercises. Okay, lesson 4 book back exercises. We are going to see all the book back exercises. Here in this video I am going to show you the answers, question answers also. Write only the question answers in your classwork. No need to write other exercises. Okay, otherwise your textbook should be filled with full of information. Okay, no field should be left blank. You have to fill all the exercises. You should attend all the exercises. All exercises I have given the answers in this video. Okay, note down. Okay, copy it in your textbook and write down the question answers in your classwork. Okay, any moment we may ask you to submit your classwork. That time you should be submitting your classwork. So we will correct and we will intimate you. That time you can collect back your classworks. Okay, without adding too much, we will continue. The first exercise in our book back is tick the correct answer. Which of the following is not a font in Microsoft Word? Okay, here you can see Cosmic Sans, MS, Calibri, Times New Roman, all are font names. But Shadow is not the font name. So this is not a font. So this is the answer. Which tab has the font group? Font group. File has the font group. Okay. Then where we find the font? That is what the question. Okay. Which option is used to make the selected text underlined? Under U. U is the option. Okay. If you select this option, the selected text would be underlined. How many ways can text be aligned in a Word document? How many ways? It is four way. It is not written here. Okay, it is four way. Left, right, center and justify. These are the four ways a text can be aligned. Four is the right answer. Okay, then which option aligns selected text to both the left and right edges of the pages? Okay, justify option aligns the selected text to both the left and right edges of the pages. If you see the text after giving justify, after selecting this option, the right side and left side both would be aligned. There won't be any gap at all. Okay, which of the following group of a home tab is used to create a numbered list? Okay, numbered list from MS Office document, that is a paragraph. Okay, from paragraph is a group of the home tab. Which of the following can be used to change the vertical space between two adjacent lines of the paragraph? That is space between every sentences. Okay, the space between the, we are asking you to leave a line and write and all, we are telling no. So that why we are telling you so, because the space between the sentence will give you the rich look to the text. The same way in computer, the to give proper space between the sentences, we are doing so. So line spacing is the right option for this. Then write the keyboard shortcuts. To open, it is Ctrl O. To close, it is Ctrl W. To align the text, it is Ctrl R. To select the entire document, Ctrl A. To add a new document, Ctrl N. Okay, so this open, close and all selecting is not necessary. For new also not necessary, but for aligning and to select and all, we have to select the document. After selecting only we can align. After selecting only we can give Ctrl A. So to select only we are giving Ctrl A. Okay, so you should understand where and all commands has to be given after selecting. Okay, to copy we should give Ctrl C after selecting the text. to paste, we have to give it just like that. We can give to cut after selecting only, we can give control X like that. Some commands are to be used only after selecting the text. Then identify the name, the following icons used for formatting text in MS Office. Okay, see this icon is for, first icon is for align the text left, second icon is for line spacing, third icon is for bulleted list, and the fourth one is for numbering the list. Okay, then correct the statement. Each letter, number or symbol used in a text document is called a font. Yes, it is it true? No, it is called a character, not a font. Only the style is called as font. In a new document, Word aligns text by default to right margin. Okay, in a new document, Word aligns text by default to the right margin. No, it is wrong. It is by left margin. The bullet command is present in the font group of the home tab. Yes, it is true. Then line spacing is the horizontal space between two adjacent line. Okay, two adjacent line of a paragraph. It is false. Text can be underlined by clicking on the B button. Okay, that means bold. Okay, bold button. It is false. Okay, underline means U only we are supposed to select. We are supposed to select only U. Only then the text would be underlined. Okay, using keyboard shortcut is slower than using a mouse. Using keyboard shortcut is slower than the using mouse. No, it is faster. So in this way it is false. Then fill in the blanks. Each letter, number or symbol used in a text document is called character, not the font. You will find the numbering option in the paragraph group of the home tab. The default line spacing is a Word document is set at 1.0. Okay, this is the line spacing number we are giving, means giving a gap between two sentence, two lines. The default there are four options to align the text. Okay, how many options? Left, right, center and justify are the four options. Okay, look at the paragraph given below. Write down the format used in this paragraph. See the paragraph, look at this paragraph. Left side there is a uneven gap, and same similarly left and right, both the sides are uneven, but in center it is even, so it is aligned in center. Okay, then number the steps in the correct order to print a document. To print a document, what are all the steps to be followed? The first step is click on the print option on the file tab. Okay, from the file tab we have to select the option called print. Then choose whether you want to print all the pages or a selected number of pages, so that is 2. Then the third one is choose whether you want to print on one side or both the side of the pages, so that is 3. Then type the number of copies you want to copy. Okay, then that is 4. Then the last one, you will click on print to print a document. Okay, so these are the steps involved to print a document. Then label the option on the given picture. Okay, these are the options. Okay, left alignment, justify, center alignment, right alignment. Okay, then question answers. These question answers you have to write in your classwork. Okay, these are the question answers you have to write in your classwork. What is font? A character designed in a particular way is called a font. Okay, a character designed in a particular way is called a font. Which option helps you to change the font color? Okay, font color, red color, blue color, green color and all color, in which color you want to type a text. The font color drop down arrow in the font group of the home tab helps you to change the font color. Okay, then differentiate between the character and the font. Character, each letter, number or symbol used in a text document is called a character, but a character designed in a particular way is called a font. Okay, all are character only, whatever you type is character, but the style you choose is a font. Then what is a character? Each letter, number or symbol used in a text is called character. Okay, each letter, number or symbol used in a text is called a character. Write the steps to change the font color of selected text. Okay, write the steps to change the font color. Okay, font color of the selected text. Select the text, click on the font color drop down arrow in the font group of the home tab. Okay, then what do you mean by alignment of a text? Write its type. Okay, alignment of the text, n number of times I told you, we saw a picture also. Okay, in the exercise number H, label the options on the given picture. Okay, the same question only here. Alignment of a text implies its arrangement on the page. There are four types of alignments, namely left, right, center, justify alignments. Okay, these are the four. Then write the steps to create bulleted list in the Word document. Okay, in a Word document, write the steps to create a bulleted list. Select the list. First we have to select the list. Click on the drop down arrow of the bulleted option in the paragraph group of the home tab. Choose a style from the library. Okay, these are the three steps involved. First you have to select the list. Okay, which list you want to make it as a bulleted point. Then click on the drop down arrow of the bullet option. There will be a bullet option under paragraph group under home tab. Select on that. There will be many styles like tick mark and bulleted points. Okay, then numbers, everything, or ABC 1 2 3, everything will be there. Select, then choose a style from the library. That is choosing the style. Okay, from the library. Then click on okay. Okay, that's it. Then what is the difference between line spacing and paragraph spacing? Okay, line spacing means, line spacing is a vertical space between two adjacent line of the paragraph. Okay, between two lines, whatever the space we are leaving, that is a line spacing. Okay, how we are writing in a classwork, okay, we are leaving a line in between and writing. Why we are doing so? We are giving a certain amount of space between two lines, so that is called line spacing. Okay, paragraph spacing, it is a vertical space before and after a paragraph. Okay, the first line in a paragraph will give some amount of a gap, then we will start, then we will continue. Okay, the left side and right side, we will leave a good amount of margin. Okay, these are all called as paragraph spacing. Okay, up to this only 8 questions are there. Okay, up to this your classwork. Okay, the 8 questions has to be written in your classwork. All the 8 questions you have to write in your classwork. Okay, rest all you should be filling out with your textbook. Okay, textbook, these are all you have to fill with textbook. Okay, write in your textbook. Okay, classwork should contain only the question answers. Classwork should contain only the question answers. Textbook only should have the all exercise answers. Okay, clearly I'm telling you again and again. Okay, that's all for this class. We'll meet in next class. Okay, already lesson 5 video I have posted. Okay, I've given you the message also. Actually that was 5th lesson. Okay, that was the 5th lesson video. Okay, fill that also, use that also in your lesson 5. Okay, fill that also in your lesson 5. The same way, write the question answers in your lesson 5. Okay, classwork has to be completed with your question answers. Understand, kids? Okay, we'll meet in next class. Bye.